This is Pogo. Pogo is an artificial intelligence agent with a small brain, but a huge problem. His beer supplies are under attack. As you might have noticed, Pogo has a godlike physique, and believe it or not, these shapes aren't easily achieved. To maintain his curves, Pogo heavily relies on his precious beer, so he must fortify his base in time to stop the advancing monsters. And if you're thinking, what monsters? These guys are hella cute. Well, you better don't stand between them and beer. In this video, we'll see how an AI can learn all by himself to play a tower defense game. We will find out what strategies the AI will deem best and how those strategies change depending on the map. Which towers will the AI choose and what pattern will it use to place them? And last but not least, how will the AI manage to break the simulation this time? If you saw the previous tower defense video, you might have noticed that the simulation changed quite a lot, so let me explain how it all works. I have a text file called map, where I can draw any map I want simply by replacing or adding values from 0 to 3, which basically means there are 4 tiles. Tile 0, or the grass tile, are the cells where Pogo is able to build towers, or rather, as we will see in just a minute, demolishing them. Tile 1 is a road tile, and those are used for enemies pathfinding, paving the way from the spawner to the goal. Pogo is unable to build anything on the road. Talking about spawners, tile 2 is where all the enemies get spawned and where I can control stuff like amount of waves and their contents, spawn frequencies and so on. There can be only one spawner on the map, and if you're wondering why there can't be multiple places where the enemies will spawn, the answer is simple. I tried doing that, up, couldn't be bothered to fix it and moved on. Last but not least, some would argue this is actually the most important tile, the beer tile, aka the goal. That's where our thirsty enemies will head towards for a good time. Whenever an enemy eventually gets his hands on the sweet, sweet beer supplies, it will deal an amount of damage to the total health based on that enemy's level. Currently, there are 4 levels of enemies. The rat is the first enemy Pogo will encounter, thus the weakest. Being a level 1 enemy, it means it will deal only 1 damage to Pogo's supplies. Below you can see the stats a rat has. Next, on our list are level 2 enemies, the turtles. The unit is much slower, but also has 3 times the health points of a rat. Level 3 enemies are the penguins, and these unique units are airborne, which means they can't be targeted by certain tower types, but we'll get back to that in just a moment after the last enemy, a level 4 walrus boss. This behemoth of an animal has a ton of HP and will put the AI strategy under a stress test. Now regarding the towers I've mentioned. There are no 2 towers that are twins in this game. All 3 buildings have unique and distinct features that will result in their according strengths and weaknesses, while all of them cost the same amount of 200 coins. Ranger Tower has a damage of 50 points, meaning it will one-shot level 0 red enemies and it will shoot 1 projectile every second. Moreover, it can attack any type of units, both airborne and groundborne. Anyways, the second building type is the Ice Tower. While dealing absolutely no damage, it can shoot 3 projectiles per second, freezing enemies it hits and reducing their movement speed in half. Another unique feature of this construction is the way it targets enemy. Compared to the Ranger, for example, instead of constantly focusing the first enemy, aka the enemy closest to the goal, the Ice Tower will target the first enemy who is not under the frozen debuff, thus ensuring that there are as many slowed enemies as possible. It is also able to shoot any unit type. Lastly, we have the Cannon Tower, which technically is a catapult lol. Low attack speed of 1 projectile in 3 seconds isn't an issue for this bad boy thanks to the huge damage it can deal. Not only the enemy hit by the cannonball will instantly lose 75 health points, but also all its neighbors in a 2-meter radius will experience the same fate. This, however, doesn't apply to airborne units, since the Cannon Tower can't damage them at all. As I mentioned previously, a tower that was built can also be demolished, which will demolish the building and give Pogo 100 coins back. Pogo will have to learn and adapt all by himself for all the different enemies and use various tower combinations to protect his stash, and he will do that thanks to reinforcement learning. Long story short, Poco is spoon-fed an entire list of observations, 97 to be precise, which includes stuff like information about each tile, what tower and where those are built, the spawned enemies and their stats, beer supplies left, his position and rotation, and so on. This information is then lobotomized into his artificial brain, and after some math I'm too dumb and lazy to explain, our AI comes up with some decisions such as move, rotate, build, or demolish. He will then be judged based on the results of his actions. Pogo gets a reward for dealing damage to enemies and completing waves, while getting punished for every unit of beer lost and simply for existing. Okay, look, usually the existence punishment served an actual purpose. An agent punished for every second of his existence would be motivated to complete the given task as fast as possible, hence getting a punishment as low as possible. This time, however, the environment duration is predefined by the number of waves there are, and Pogo can't really complete the task faster, so the existence punishment doesn't really serve any other purpose than making Pogo's life more miserable, and that's more than enough for me. Pogo will start with a small loan of 500 coins, which is worth 2.5 towers, bootstrapping his business until he creates a steady income source. For each slayed enemy, Pogo will be rewarded 10 coins, multiplied by the level of that unit, so killing a rat will result in 10 coins, turtle 20, and so on. We will have 5 waves with scaling difficulty. First wave will consist of only 10 rats, with a spawn interval of 2 seconds. This wave will allow Pogo to get a taste of the game before getting shoved headfirst into the harsh reality of wave 2. Now, Pogo will have to fight off 50 rats with a spawn interval of 75 milliseconds, basically more than 1 per second. If our brave warrior manages to fight off the rat plague, before he manages to catch his breath, a horde of 50 turtles would start pushing forward, spawning with 1 second intervals. Next goes the penguin army. Again, 50 units with intervals of 75 milliseconds. And as you can see, each penguin has a random name and skin. These are the legendary people subscribed to my Patreon page. Huge thanks for supporting the channel, and now to the last wave. The Walrus boss. Only one chunky unit that really wants beer. The training went pretty well, except the part in the beginning where Pogo couldn't stop demolishing his towers a second after placing them himself. But his stupidity wasn't long-lived, because only few hundreds episodes later, this dum-dum managed to break the simulation. Somehow they always managed to find a way to do this. If you haven't noticed, the AI basically started placing a tower in the exact moment the round was being reset, which made it possible for the tower to be built several tiles away from Pogo. Well, I tried solving it as I solve most of my problems, I ignored it and pretended it isn't there. Several training days later, and yes, when I say training days, I mean literally several dozen hours of non-stop training of about 40 instances in parallel. So after a lot of training, this dum-dum has finally figured out that placing towers on tiles surrounded by roads is a great idea, since it can damage enemies all around itself. However, he's still suffering from demolishing them right away, but at least these two are fine. Righty, enough yapping, time for some action. And after more than 100 hours of training, let's first see the final results on the same map. Round starts with 2 ranger towers being placed in the bottom left corner of the map, followed by some frantic running. After clearing the first wave, Pogo built an ice tower right behind the spawn point, which will slow all enemies that get hit by the rangers. Nice synergy, and it is definitely working. Despite wave 2 having much more rats, the distance they can cross before getting shot seems smaller. The moment Pogo farmed another 200 coins, he places another ranger next to the ice tower. I'm wondering why no cannons so far, but let's keep watching. Wave 2 is over and oh, there they are! Pogo demolished the archer tower and built 2 catapults instead. That's definitely much more efficient, and there goes the third one. Since enemies give more coins now, Pogo can afford to build yet another ranger right away. It looks like he got a little bit confused between the 4 towers, while coins kept flowing. What happens next, though, actually impressed me. It is very easy to write it off as randomness, but the time precision makes me think it was premeditated. The moment the penguin wave started, Pogo sells the catapult and places a ranger tower instead. He then immediately demolishes it, but then he puts it back. Well, he can afford it, my boy is rich. That being said, keep in mind that penguins do not take damage from catapults, so him selling the catapult to place a ranger tower shows he has pretty good understanding on what the hell is going on. Hope he doesn't mind the existence punishment, lol. The walrus boss came and almost instantly died. Pretty impressive! Pogo actually succeeded at completing the level and protected 100% of his beer supplies. But what if he gets thrown on a map he didn't see before? I asked you guys to submit some map suggestions on Discord and ended up settling with this one, which looks like a rocket ship. Talking about Discord, check out the awesome art that some of you made. I love it. Keep them coming. Round 2 surprised me even more. Here, Pogo starts with a different strategy, where he places a ranger and an ice tower in the lower right corner. But the cool thing isn't just that. He then rushes to the other side of the map, and despite demolishing a tower right after building it, Pogo places a catapult right next to the road. This basically shows us that Pogo didn't remember what is the best strategy for a specific map layout, but he actually learned and is able to adapt his strategy depending on the map. Moreover, you can notice how he always tries to pair an ice tower with any other building, because he figured out it makes for a great combo. Few penguins manage to pass by, so he immediately takes countermeasures and places some more rangers, or some catapults, or some rangers. Anyways, the walrus is spawned, but I bet it wished it did not happen, because he immediately gets blasted from all sides. The last penguin is dead, and so is the walrus. So, another win, and this seemed even easier, which I guess makes sense. Larger map means more time for enemies to travel, and more space to build towers, thus more potential damage. That being said, I still think that Pogo did a great job learning all of that by himself. By the way, I often get asked how I do this or that project, and the truth is, once you get comfortable with programming, I believe you can make almost anything. And getting started has never been as easy thanks to the sponsor of today's video, Brilliant. Brilliant is where you learn by doing, with thousands of interactive courses in math, data analysis, programming, and AI. Each lesson is crafted by an award-winning team of teachers and researchers, with a focus on hands-on experience that develops critical thinking and fosters a programming mindset. And if you don't have much free time, that isn't an issue. Brilliant's fun and concise lessons allow you to learn anywhere and whenever you have time, right from your phone. The always increasing number of programming courses are a great way to build the necessary foundations, like getting familiar with Python by building programs on day one with a built-in drag-and-drop editor, or learning essential coding elements, from loops and variables to nesting and conditionals. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/zuzeloapps or scan the QR code on the screen. Or you can click on the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!